Apple and Intel rumored to be working on a watch. Toshiba working on bringing Lytro technology to mobile cameras. And wait, what? Windows RT was ported to the HTC HD2. I'm Jaime Rivera, and just like Bruce Willis, there are just some phones that die hard. This is Pocket Now Daily. That's right, the new batch of rumors have Apple working on an iWatch, which comes at a sense of irony since they pretty much ditched the only iPod that could actually ever be worn as a watch. Now, the interesting part of these news is when you add Intel into the mix because, well, you really know that their mobile processors have really not shined at all. But you never know what could happen when you join these two companies together to see what they could come up with, so we'll keep you posted. Now, when it comes to some real innovation, Toshiba seems to be working on bringing Lytro technology to mobile phone cameras. And for those of you that don't know, the Lytro camera is famous for allowing you to take a photo right now and eventually coming back to the photograph in the future and selectively focusing different parts of the shot and making as many copies of that photograph as you want with different focus points. It's really genius, though the Lytro camera hasn't really been important in the market just yet, but just think about it. Think about your smartphone camera taking a photo now and then wanting to focus on something different in the future. I think it's kind of genius. Let's see if it happens eventually. Yes, we've got some more rumors of the Sony Odin and Sony Yuga devices with some photographs of the devices side by side. Now, if you look at the photograph, one looks pretty much bigger than the other, but they're actually the same phone with the same specs, including a 1080p display. And apparently, the only difference is that these devices will be launched at different markets. Now, Sony has run out of the alphabet, and we are hoping that they come up with something good this time. Apparently, these devices will be launched at CES 2013, and we will be there live to cover everything, so stay tuned. And as I started the show, it is true, there are some devices that are just hard to kill. Such as the case of the HTC HD2 that's been ported to run everything but iOS, even though I'm sure there's somebody out there that's already figured that one out. It's now being shown in images running Windows RT. Just think about it, a device that's older than dirt running a new tablet operating system. And that begs the question, I mean, how many of you are actually still using an HTC HD2? I think that's the hardest part of the news. And finally, for the usual news of the day, Google has just announced their top number one applications of the year in the Google Play Store. And ironically, some of these applications weren't really 2012 applications, but still most likely chosen because of how popular they are, such as the case of Evernote, Pocket, and other applications. The list is quite big, so follow the links in the description for details. But that leads me to the question of the day. If you had to pick just one application from the Google Play Store, just one, which would be your favorite application, the ones you love the most? In my particular case, SwiftKey 3 is worth every single penny. I would buy it twice if I had to. Leave us a comment down below, which is your favorite application? And if you want an earlier scoop of everything that's happening in the smartphone and tablet world, make sure you follow us on PocketNow.com. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I'm Jaime Rivera. Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow. For a computer, or pretty much a tablet if you could say... There. A little bit more. All right. All right.